We found this on Twitter, and really we found it by listening to what's going on, the discussion around the league. NHL Prospects Watcher tweeting this out. Brian Burke on whether Mitch Marner should get similar money to Auston Matthews on Primetime Sports with Gord Stellick hosting. Quote, hard to refute that, isn't, I love Auston Matthews, but he ain't selling tickets. He ain't exciting. Mitch Marner is exciting. Hashtag Leafs forever. What in the world? Lots. Let's look at the numbers here. Auston Matthews, we always talk about this, the first Leaf ever to have 30 goals or more his first 3 years. What do you make of it?
Burke, he speaks from the heart. I respect him for that. I just don't agree with him.
Okay.
In this particular case, I think Auston Matthews is incredibly exciting to watch, number one. Number two, the fact of the matter is, whether or not you agree or disagree with me, Auston Matthews is the better player, but more importantly, Mitch Marner is not going to make anywhere near what Auston Matthews is making. I hope that he does, but you're going to have to introduce me to some new forms of math that I'm not aware of, because it just doesn't work.
Slices of the pie.
What's going to happen,
yeah,
you'll hear it, not right here first, I'm sure you'll hear it from lots of other people, he's going to end up on a shorter-term deal, and that's how you sell it. Because there's no other options, Weeksy. We can't just create money out of thin air in a salary cap situation. So for Mitch Marner, he's going to have to buy into the fact that, hey, you know what? I'll be back to the market before Auston Matthews. I might make more when we run a model of how many years, but he's not going to make more on a yearly basis. Now, he might make more in one single year or something like that, but at the end of the day, the AAV will be less than Auston Matthews.
You can only get so creative,
mm-hmm,
in creative accounting.
Yeah. So, I mean a lot less, just for the record.
Exactly.
I'm not talking 500,000.
Yeah, no. And
it,
I mean,
it doesn't work.
Well, that's the whole thing. Unless they start moving bodies out. Unless you start moving out bodies and you move two bodies that
great
are going to total that
we
same.
We should go back and play.
Exactly. That are going to total that same salary that you're projected to pay, potentially,
yes,
to pay Mitch Marner. But here's the thing, man. Listen, I grew up in Toronto. Here's the biggest thing. There was no player ever in the history of the Leafs ever that I remember in my, being born in 75.
Mm-hmm.
Going up, okay, wow, Wendell Clark. Oh, my gosh, he burst on the scene. Wendell Clark. What Auston Matthews has done is historic.
Hello.
It is.
It's just, it's never happened, yeah, before in an original six franchise. He's made history.
Mm-hmm.
So if you look at the numbers, and the numbers kind of bear fruit on both sides. You,
yes,
look at it from Auston Matthews.
We're not
Matthews
saying Mitch isn't exciting.
Exactly.
He's totally excited.
He's awesome.
Sure.
So is Auston Matthews.
Exactly.
Yes.
And what's actually impressive is they both come with different paths.
Right.
I love the fact that Auston Matthews is California-born, Arizona-trained.
Here we go.
American-born, stud, went to Switzerland, stud, came back, stud, instant,
right,
splash.
Mm-hmm.
And I also love the fact, as a kid that grew up playing in the GTHL and one of the few graduates of the league that played in the league, in the National Hockey League, Mitch Marner, as a fellow Toronto kid, grew up in their backyard.
Mm-hmm.
Years past, they would have ignored,
right,
that.
Great story.
They would have ignored that.
Very
and
totally
seen it when,
totally,
he was in Pee-wee, when he was in Bantam, when,
totally,
he was in Midget. And, oh, sorry, we can't see that. We've got our blinders on. No, he's from here, so we can't. So I just think that they're in a great situation, in short, to be able to have both of them. But from a contract standpoint, I agree with you. Auston Matthews, remember I told you, he's going to go the shorter term. He did. And I think for Mitch Marner, to your point,
he's going
to
shorter
go
term,
even shorter term if he wants to get his full comp on a per year basis.
Yeah.
But they'll be creative, but they're sitting pretty when you have two of those young future foundational pieces that already stars. You're sitting pretty.
Mitch Marner could always reject the concept that I just won't play for less. He
yeah,
could
very
accept
well do that
and do that.
Yes.
I don't think he will.
Yeah.
I think the Toronto Maple Leafs have reinvented themselves. I think players are looking at it more seriously as a destination than ever.
Mm-hmm.
And I think Mitch Marner, in watching him play on a nightly basis, loves playing in Toronto.
Mm.
He does not look like he doesn't like it. Let's put it that
true
way.
True.
And he's,
yeah,
incredibly exciting.
He's awesome.
You've got all this talent. I'm hearing you guys talk about these incredible opportunities. So what about the coach, Mike Babcock? Two straight regulation losses, two poor starts. You start to wonder, in a market that has that much scrutiny and that much pressure, how about how much of it falls on him, Lotz, when you look at the commitment that they made to him financially to bring him there? How much pressure is on Mike Babcock right now?
I think Mike always feels pressure. I don't think there's ever been much on him publicly because his credentials are impeccable. When you look at what he's done in this game, it's amazing. But the one thing that you hear just a little bit sometimes is not necessarily as much recent playoff success as you'd like to see.
Sure.
And at some point, just the nature of this beast that is the NHL, that's going to spotlight on him a little bit. It can only go so long on the makeup, the players, this, that, or anything. In a city like Toronto, there is no place to hide.
Right.
And Mike Babcock knew that when he took the largest coaching contract in the history of the game.
Ever.
As far as I'm concerned.
Ever.
I mean, maybe we could say grats, but that would be an amalgamation as to how we would get there.
Right.
The fact of the matter is that's the largest coaching contract ever. Mike earned it. Mm-hmm. And at some point, if the Leafs don't have a big playoff run, yes, they will be looking squarely at him.
Challenge for the Leafs now is they've got all the pieces. We just talked about it. I still think their defense is their Achilles heel. Mm-hmm. But they're lucky and they're fortunate that they went out proactively. As I said, they got Freddie Anderson. That, to me, is the key. We could talk about all the other players. If you don't have a goalie in the net, then it's not happening. So Freddie Anderson's done a great job for them. They were very smart in projecting and getting that cost certainty, signing him 5x5. Amazing value ROI that they're getting on him. The defense is still a challenge for me. That and their team defense, not only the defensive core, their team defense. But offensively, they got all the pieces.
Oh,
but
weapons.
The key now, and I'm not really absolving Mike Babcock of any responsibility, but hey, listen, man, look. Everybody's getting free cars. You haven't won anything. You hear me say this all the time.
Yeah.
I'm from there.
Yeah.
Everybody, free car, two free cars, two free Porsches,
yeah.
Two free Lamborghinis, Mercedes. Yeah, man, hey, here you go, no problem. Audi, no problem. You're getting Bentleys. You got to play.
Mm-hmm.
They haven't won anything.
Mm-hmm.
If you're in Chicago, you got to earn. When you're in New York here, you got to earn. When you're in the L.A., you got to earn it. And a lot of guys are getting a lot of fruits off the tree. They got to start climbing the tree. They've got some great pieces. But they haven't done anything quite yet. I love the turnaround. I love what Brendan Shanahan and Lou Lamoriello, who's now gone, Kyle Dubas, what they've done with the group. But now the onus falls on the players. You got to be ready to play. Yeah. You're getting big cake.